want you to enjoy the celebration. It's all about Jesus Christ today and His Lord. This program that we put was a brainchild of mine years ago, and we kind of got together with Wally and Brother Kevin. He was directing the theatrical part, and we sat down and redid the whole thing and picked out more songs that we grew up today. So I appreciate the church getting behind us and just telling the story of the life of Christ from the beginning. Because there's always a beginning.
Yeah.
And so the first songs, we'll say, well, this sounds like Christmas. Well, we're talking about the birth of Christ. We're talking about the Son of God going through His life. But I'm thankful for a Christ who lives today. And I found this, it said, He who was the source of all joy, the giver of all peace, He before whom angels and archangels bow in adoration, is also called a man of sorrows. Grief broke his heart, crushed out his life. He sorrowed all alone, but He shares thy grief. He carries all of thy sorrows and comforts those who trust in Him. Shall we not worship and adore the man of sorrows today? John 16:33 said, In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Matthew 16:8-16, Peter made a great statement where he said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Worship with us as we present Jesus. He is the Son of God.
Turn the flow of crimson into fresh.
Did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to you? That your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's birthday plan? This sleeping child you hold dear is the
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth to Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. She brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, for unto you is born in this day of the city of David, which is Christ the Lord. And ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God, saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us go now even to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. They came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them by the angel. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the angels and by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things which they had heard and seen as it was told unto them.
Thank you.
Aren't you glad that Jesus came and gave his life? Amen. We need to celebrate that and give God all of our praise. Amen. And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor with God. And from that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
David's offspring. I am your high priest.
Jesus went out as usual to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples followed him. On reaching the place, he said to them, "Pray that you will not fall into temptation." And he withdrew about a stone's throw beyond them, knelt down, and began to pray. "Father, if you are willing, let this cup pass from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done." And he came to his disciples and found them asleep. And he said unto them, "Could you not watch with me 1 hour?" Immediately, while he was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, came accompanied by a crowd with swords and clubs, who with the chief priests and the scribes and the elders, they laid their hands on him and arrested him, and they led him away.
I
He's not dead. Wipe the tears from your eyes. And if you cry, rejoice in tears of joy, not of sadness. For my Redeemer lives, and He lives forevermore. As we portray the story today, in our small human way, cannot express the heavens and the glory that God the Father rejoices each and every moment, because around the throne of God, the angels proclaim, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." And seated at the right hand of the Father is Jesus Christ, the intercessor, who rose on that third day, and who has not suffered defeat, never suffered defeat, gave His life for a ransom for many. The writer so described it, and he said, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever, and I was one of those, but Christ died and He rose again for me." Truly, He is the Christ, the Son of the living God, who gave His life for us.
Amen.
Of all the places you could have went today, you chose to be here. And I believe the Spirit of the Lord has dealt with some people. And it would not be right for us to end this service unless we give you an opportunity to receive Christ into your life. Every single day, people go out into eternity, and to face that eternity without a living Christ in your heart would be a travesty. So as the music begins to play lightly, and you would bow your head, if there's one in this place who would say, "I don't know Jesus as my personal Savior. Or maybe I once knew Him a little longer. Do I walk in the way that He lives? And I need to come back to the fold." Right where you're at today, you can say, "Lord, come into my heart. Touch my life. I know that I'm not living like I should." In fact, probably all of us could just make that claim that we don't live like we should. But there's a distinction when Christ covers our sin with His blood. No work of my own. No power of my own. No turning of leaf or trying to do right. But simply finding forgiveness at the feet of Christ. Not just a picture on the wall. Not just a story in a book, but a real Christ, whose name is Jesus. Nobody's been like Him. And He will be a friend and a shepherd all to you if you'll accept Him today. So we're going to pray. While we're praying, you can pray and ask the Lord to come to your heart. Or, if you've already served the Lord and said, "Lord, I just need to do better because You've paid such a great price. Now, Father, we come to You in the name of Jesus. We thank You, Lord, for these who have celebrated with us today. We think about Your life and what You have been to us, and know today without You that the wages of sin will bring death to our life. But God, we can find the gift of Christ that is eternal through You. The price, the purchase that You made on Calvary. Lord, You're not in the tomb. You no longer hang on a cross. But You're in the heavens. And the angels declared to those that were around that day as Jesus ascended to the heavens. And they said to them, "This same Jesus whom you've seen go away shall come again." Jesus says to us that where I am, there you may be also. Lord, we look for that promise. Lord, under our hearing today, Lord, if there's one who doesn't know You, Lord, I pray that they'll accept Christ and make Him their Savior. By a simple prayer, Lord Jesus, believe that you died for me and that you rose again, and the promise that you're coming for your church, your people. And I know, God, today that we live in sin. I pray, God, today that you will give us forgiveness. We will walk away from that old life. Our future is before us, and our old man is behind us. Save us now by your precious blood, and that we may rejoice in you and give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Can you give the Lord a hand clap?